Whew. Oh boy.
I just need foot room, so.
Back you go.
Go for it.
All right. Ah. All right. Guys. So we just saw the most expensive Fantastic Four 2 prequel I've ever seen. Should we talk about the movie first, or should we talk about the experience we had just like 5 seconds ago? So we didn't like it. I think that's what we're saying right off the bat. But we were just like, we were walking back to the elevator to get to the garage, and we were just like, and you were like, ah. I was like, yeah, that was stupid. And just then, like, this mother and her son came in. It was like no more than like four or five.
Yeah.
And she's like, she looks at us and goes, "You guys see Gods of Egypt? Pretty good, huh?" And you and I just looked at each other like, dude, shut up. Just and we just ran past them because we're trying hard not to laugh our ass off.
Oh, that was a better moment in the entire freaking movie.
I know. I just like, this is one of those movies that is such a gigantic flop and such a no one gave a shit movie that if the director didn't throw a gigantic hissy fit for critics not liking his movie, I probably wouldn't be here talking about it. But
No, you would have. You would have been here regardless.
And I almost skipped this because it was clear it's already on its way out of theaters. And it was like Gem and the Hologram.
Yay!
It's like, that being said, I did get a lot of shit for not seeing Gem and the Holograms, so I guess, for like the week that was in theaters.
So. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. We didn't get the chance to see it too after it disappeared.
I know. That really was it. Like, we were going to go see it. Then, like, it went out, like, the next
2 weeks.
It wasn't even that. It was like,
no, they took it out after the second weekend.
I know, but it was like in the first weekend, they're still like, they reduced from like for 10 show times to 2. And it was like, none of them worked. It's like, okay. There's no reason to see this now. Apparently there was, because apparently people want me to hear me bitch about it. But you can hear me bitch about this movie instead. Man, this was colossally stupid.
Stupid and boring as hell. And my God, how do you make $140 million look cheap?
I know, right? Like, there's a couple, like, effects, like, okay, that wasn't that bad. Like, I got used to it. I don't even know.
No, for me, it was so inconsistent.
It was.
Like, there are times
where I'm not the only one that knows. After a certain point, I was like, am I just getting used to this? Is it getting better? Because, like, sometimes it just looks awful. It just, like, looks okay. Oh, like,
was it when the guy, like, swing across or was like,
oh, my God. That looked like the old, like, that looked like NES Prince of Persia. That's what I was thinking of watching. I'm going to turn the air because it's a bit warm in here. But
I was like, oh, my God. How does Deadpool get better special effects than this?
They know how to fucking use it. This seems like,
With almost a third of the budget.
And here's the thing, like, I have, like, after hearing, like, director's huge rant about how, oh, you just don't like, everyone just likes to parrot the other people's opinions, like, no, you just made a bad movie. Look at what you made. How can you really justify this?
On the bright side, at least he apologized for casting nothing but white people before it came out.
True.
And the funny thing is, he's actually Egyptian, too.
Yeah, I heard about that. So I was like, I don't know. It's like, I remember, like, was it with, like, Honest Trailers did one, something about that, where, about Exodus.
Oh,
yeah. Or some, like, guy goes, you need star power for this kind of movie. It's like, yeah, and then show a picture of, Ramesses, and he goes, yeah, because who can deny the star power of whoever the fuck this is?
Yeah. All I remember is that he was it Zartan in, freaking G.I. Joe.
Yeah, exactly. No one remembers who the fuck that guy was. But
or the guy who was also in, oh my God. Yeah, I forgot the other guy's name too. The other guy who was in The Mummy. The one who was like the other good guy paired up with Brendan Fraser. The guy also, Odette Fair. There we go.
Oh, God. This movie is just, there's no reason this needs to be 2 hours long. It thinks it's more clever than it is.
Yeah.
The CGI is so terrible. You're right, it is incredibly inconsistent. I was like, oh my God, it's so painfully obvious they're in front of a green screen. I was like, okay, that actually wasn't that bad. But it's so like touch and go, it's like, there's one was like, okay, it didn't look that bad. I was just like, ha, that looks dumb. Like when Captain Barbosa like grows like 10 feet tall.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, my God. I mean, okay. No, you go ahead.
No, oh god, it was just so boring. And it's like, the thing is, like, it wasn't even bad enough to really be angry at. It was just so, it was just boring.
It's just stupid. I guess it came down to, for me, like, right after the bat, it's like, it's just, the dialogue feels stilted and painful, and yeah. Like, even then, I just feel like, I don't know how Egyptian dress was back in the day, but it just feels like all the women's dresses just had their boobs just falling out of these things.
That was, yeah, I don't care if people say we sound misogynistic, but that was probably the only, like, worthy thing in this.
That's right. The only thing worth watching Gods of Egypt was the tits. I mean, I can't really judge too much. I did call that woman from Point Break, what I call her, pretentious tits. That's what I called her. Because all she was a pair of boobs that spat a bunch of philosophical bullshit. And that was her only purpose. So I called her pretentious tits. And I'm hoping to make that a
pretentious
t-shirt. That's what it was, yeah. It's hard to say. Try saying that three times fast. It's hard to do.
Yeah.
But either way, I want to make that a t-shirt. Make it like a pair of boobs with glasses. Talking about kale and organic. Save the whales. Anyway, sorry. I got lost in a pair of pretentious tits. But seriously, like, I was more like, I mean, I'm not the most PC guy in the world. I mean, I like to think I'm more open-minded than a lot of people. But at the same time, even this point, I'm like, okay, I can enjoy a nice pair of boobs every now and again. But this just feels gratuitous, even by my standards. But I mean, granted, I read comic books. I still read comic books. It's hard to argue that there's some unfairness curve there. And quite frankly, some impossible curves a lot of the time.
Oh, yeah.
But I don't know. Just something about that kind of bug makes me laugh. It's like, fucking really? You're going to like defend this as high-class art when you have fucking tits everywhere? I don't know. That just...
Tasteful, though. It was PG-13.
As tasteful as they can make it, really. Yeah. Like, these scenes are practically just gonna... I know we're spending a lot of time on tits right now, but, so seriously, though, it's so bad! Like, in the first scene, it's like, I was like, first off, it was a dress I feel like I would see my friends wear, so I was like, oh yeah, that's truly Egyptian wear for Kohl's.
Yeah, even I know what you mean, though. It's like, seeing it's just like...
And, like, and next shot, I just heard just boobs just be like one jog away, and just going bloop.
Yeah, it's like, she's got huge... tracks of land.
Pretty much. It's kind of what it felt like. But it's not like the black, like Scarlett Johansson's a Black Widow, where the character is good enough that I could ignore the obvious like sexism or anything like that. I'm not even gonna call it sexism. I'm just gonna call it just gratuitous nature of the outfit.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like, it's like, no, you're just there to be a pair of talking boobs. That is your only purpose in the story.
Technically, that was especially true for the God of Love.
Yeah, exactly. Even though, like, I was like, that was more like, okay, I'm already getting sick of this, because it's like everyone else just basically walk around in bras.
Yeah.
Which, again, might be accurate. I'm inclined to doubt it, but it might be. So, yeah, if you saw the trailer, you pretty much know the story. It's about Horus, played by the Kingslayer, and
whose Swedish name I can't pronounce.
I can't either. Who's like the son of
Osiris.
Osiris, who's the brother of Seth.
Set.
I'm gonna call him Seth.
Street Fighter!
Seth.
Might as well be, now that I think about it.
Wouldn't it be great if the villain of this was Seth Green?
Seth is Seth. Oh, God. Sorry, I just thought Seth Rogen.
Oh, God. That honestly would have taken that over this. To be fair, though, Gerald Butler is, like, the only one having fun here.
Yeah, like, he's pulling off as much of Leonidas as he can.
Yeah,
I
mean,
I think there's even, I'm not sure if it was an actual reference, but they kind of, it's like, it's like, destroying everything under the sun? This is madness! And you're like, ah! Oh, that was the only moment of joy.
No, actually, the part that made me laugh was when he said, "I can understand killing for a crown." I was like, "Yeah, you would, bastard." You and your fucking bastard son, Joffrey.
Incest child. Spoiler alert.
Oh, like,
yeah.
Come on, who doesn't know that by now?
Wow, I'm just starting Game of Thrones. Now to go see a Michael the Comic review. No!
Oh, yeah, while you're still catching up on modern-day pop culture, let me spoil the end of King Kong for you. The monkey dies! Okay, so you're really, really, really far behind Passion of the Christ? Oh, boy, you're in for a killer ending. joke, just saying.
Oh, was that stupid joke where it's like, oh, man, the movie is so emotional, it's like, lady, I read the book. I knew the ending coming way before that.
Well, this isn't even about reading. Well, I guess if you read the Bible, you know how Jesus, what happens to Jesus. Yeah. Spoiler, he dies.
No, then.
That's okay. You can bring it back.
Yeah. Then you can watch the sequel, Risen.
I know. That actually wasn't a bad movie.
So I've been told.
It wasn't great by any stretch of imagination, but as far as religious movie goes, not bad.
Yeah.
It actually had a Jesus that wasn't white, so that was actually kind of refreshing. I know. Everyone right. else is white. Yeah. Actually, it's not fair. That's not true. But anywho, yeah. So...
Which means they still they had less white people than this movie did.
It did. Like, the most recent religious movies are notorious for being bigotry asshole movies. It was actually more respectful than the Gods of Egypt. Which, to be fair, there are some black people in there.
Yeah, there's like one who even had a somewhat... major part.
And I don't even know what accent he's doing or what he's doing.
I don't know what the hell he's doing either.
Like, he's trying to be Sherlock or something, and it's just coming off as well, awkwardly flamboyant.
That might have been the point.
Maybe. I don't know. It just came off as dumb and stilted.
I will admit, though, I did kind of get one laugh from him. The thing where it's like, all right, let me try. You know, let me do the thing where I was just going to tell him that he, of course, he probably would know the answer to the Sphinx. Are you gonna play on my ego? Do you really think I'm that vain?
Okay.
And there's just like nothing but a bunch of clones there, just kind of like.
Okay, yeah, let's go.
Yeah. It's like, okay, that was kind of
like,
funny.
This is just. There's so much. I mean, like, I know I rag on CGI a lot, and.
This movie deserves the ragging.
Yeah, I know, because, like, even I think the most parts I really started to notice how much it was really starting to bug me was in The Hobbit 3. I felt like even that was better than this shit. Because, like, every. Single scene in this movie you can tell is in front of a green screen.
Yeah, it's like there may be a few sets, but
one that really stuck out is like in the carriage scene after Prince of Persia, I'm gonna call him.
Yeah.
Saves Egypt tits from the tits of Egypt. There you go.
Egypt Tipsons. Or oh fuck, I messed it up.
Oh, how dare you. The Prince of Egypt and the Tits of Time are riding in a carriage together. And you can just so completely tell that they are behind a green screen and they don't even like try to hide it. It's just so insanely obvious. I was like, wow. This is like bad as that one, what was that name of that one movie where they were obviously behind a green screen? The other person had to like lean into the other person to tell them they were turning in a car. Have you ever seen that clip?
No.
It's like an old school, like from the really old movie.
Like, it's kind of, like, let me put it this way. Sometimes it was about as bad as The Room in terms of green screen.
Did The Room use green screen?
Yeah. When they're up on the rooftop, there's, like, part where that just, it's like, you spent $140 million on this. You have no excuse.
Well, is this because they used so much goddamn CGI. It's because they didn't make any sets. They didn't make any real costumes. Even in the end, you can tell just, like, Gerald Butler and the Kingslayer just look, I swear to God, look like rejected costume superheroes from the 80s. Like, it is 80s and 90s. Like, it really did have that over-the-top, skin-tight vibe to it.
Yeah.
In a way that, granted, still happens today, but they've learned how to modernize those. Like, so dumb. This looks like something Rob Liefeld would have drawn. For those who get that joke, he wrote he created Deadpool and Cable and all that stuff. But look, it was still drawings with this incredibly puffed up chest and insane proportions. Joke for nerds. Anywho. Yeah. But it's so ridiculous and it's so stupid and it is like, there's some parts that didn't look bad. I actually kind of thought Anubis looked okay. In comparison. I kind of like the design, I guess.
Yeah.
Not so much the way like it actually interacted with people, because obviously it didn't do that very well, but I thought design would actually look kind of nice. Better than anything else, in my opinion.
Fair enough.
The snakes didn't look that bad.
Yeah, like, those were one of the few good things. But,
Like, in
comparison. Yeah, it's like, how did they look awesome? The people on them are so clearly on a green screen.
I know. Well, I mean, obviously you're on a gigantic fucking snake, so of course it's green screen. Yeah. But I don't know. It's just, this felt like such a colossal waste of time when we could have been seeing Zootopia. It's okay. Yeah. We got that later this week. That's okay. We'll see it later this week. It'll be good.
Yay! Good movie!
Hopefully. Oh, that's got like, what, 98% or something ridiculous like that? Yeah. I don't know. Jesus Christ.
It was 100 for a while.
Well, yeah, that was because it was early release. That happens sometimes. But on that, like, the story is just that Set decides he wants to rule things now. Rah, 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 rah. Kills his brother.
In the most,
in like the dumbest fucking fashion, where I was like, wow, dude, you know, sometimes not okay to go for a hug.
Yeah, it's like, it's like he openly says, I'm going to fight and kill you. I will not fight you. I will show you with the power of love, Shank.
You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of that the second Dungeons and Dragons episode of Community, where the Dean goes up to Jeff and he goes, I hug my father. Ever you seen that episode?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
And Jeff's like, I see my sword, and he goes, you've been impaled. It's like, I hug my father. You've been impaled. If you don't watch Community, go watch episodes. I know I butcher these retellings because I talk fast and I mumble, but,
Oh, I love the D&D episodes.
Oh, yeah, they're great. The first one's still my all-time favorite episode of the show. That's the one I showed my friends. I was like, yes, you need to watch. This is how, like, this is why I love this show. This is why Big Bang Theory can suck more, jerk. That's a whole nother rant for another day. So that happens, and Set takes out Horus's eyes and then banishes him instead of kills him because he wants the goddess of love in the sack, I guess.
Yeah.
Who doesn't kill him for reasons that aren't explained other than, oh, you're not going to kill me.
Yeah, I don't know.
Who just another pair of just, well, at least she had more of a purpose in the story.
Yeah, she did something.
She did something, at least. But after that happens, then Prince of Egypt goes to save the Tits of Time, and then the Tits of Time dies. Yes, that's what I'm going to call her from now on, because I don't remember her name. It starts with a Z.
Zaya.
I'm still going to call her the Tits of Time. Because they were kind of like hourglasses, so it kind of works. Oh, my God. Hey, they get pierced by a dagger. No, arrow. They don't. Arrow. Oh, it'd been funny if it was a dagger.
Nope, it was an arrow.
I know. I want to keep the joke going. But anyway, so she dies, and Prince of Persia becomes convinced that, oh, Horus can save her because reasons, and then Horus is reluctant, and then they do the buddy cop thing where they eventually work together, learn to like each other, and then they go up to Captain Barbossa, who's playing Ra, which made me laugh. And then apparently it turns out the whole reason Ra is there on an Earth that's flat is because Galactus is coming, and he wants to eat Egypt. Apparently, that's the only nation that exists in this world.
He looks like it looked like a giant dune sandworm.
I just remember Galactus from Fantastic Four, too. That's all.
Yeah, it was a combo of those two. It was like, what in the hell?
And the effects didn't work as bad as everything else. But it was kind of weird, like, seeing that. That was actually okay, the animated. And then you go back to Ra, who just looks like shit. Because they have the ridiculous, like, horn, he's on fire. But it's still Captain Barbossa. Yeah. So all I can see is like, arr, come get me, you wee scallywags.
It's like, I mean, it was already kind of weird because, like, the gods are supposed to look bigger than everyone else already.
So you already have, like, again, it's just constant use of CGI. There's no actual use of practical effects. It's that misconception that a lot of directors, I feel like, have in a CGI age, where they think if you just see CGI stuff, you can still inspire that sense of wonder, which the movie is clearly trying to do. But it just, problem is, like, I know that's not there. I know that's a cartoon. So I don't have that sense of wonder, unless it's all a cartoon, in which case you can buy into that.
It's sad how Mad Max made us wonder at the desert.
Because that knew how to use its environment. Exactly. You know, it uses colors, and you said mix practical effects with CGI in a way that worked. This one is like, oh no, we're just gonna make some pretty thing to look like CGI, and we're just gonna assume you're gonna ooh ah at it.
Yeah.
Yeah. But apparently the apparently our audience liked it. So good. Wasn't that great? And I feel like a dick too for that too, because you and I just looked at it and had the exact same thought, like, dude, don't say a fucking thing. Because, like, again, it comes back to what I keep saying.
I didn't think that. I just thought, oh, you poor, poor person.
Like, no, I mean, that comes back to what I've said a million times. Like, if you like something, okay. Like, I mean, the point of this show is never to say my opinion is right and yours is wrong. It's like, okay, this is what I think. Take it as you will. You know what I mean? Because I know some people that have liked, I think a lot of fans that email me like movies that I will never like. It's never going to happen. It's not because I don't understand it. It's because I don't like it.
Anchorman!
Or, like, I've heard defenses of, like, That's My Boy.
Oh, my God, really?
Yeah, I've heard people defend
me. Anchorman, I can understand. Because, I mean, just because, you know, that at least... I'm not saying I'm a big fan either, but, you know, that actually had, like, a majority of... Well,
yeah.
In the... Leans in the positive spectrum of people who enjoy it. But That's My Boy is almost, like, universally hated.
Not really. It's got 27% of Rotten Tomato. Some people like it.
Oh. That was actually more than I thought. But still, that's... I'm surprised.
Me too. But, yeah, it goes back to, it's like, everyone just has different tastes. And yep. I'm like, well, your legs are going to be different than what I like. And that's perfectly fine.
Kind of like how I was just thought The Witch and Goodnight Mommy are just kind of, you know, they're decent.
But... Yeah, I really like those movies. Yeah. So it's like, and that's your opinion, that's my opinion. Yeah. Even though, like, I give you shit for it. Because you're my friend, I've known you for a long time, so I feel like I can.
Yeah.
I don't think you're a bad person for not liking those movies, even though you kind of are. I'm kidding.
But like, I didn't say I didn't like them, I just said I didn't like them that much.
I know, I'm giving you shit.
Fair enough.
And I was like, that's just like, that's your opinion. You're gonna like what you're gonna like, and I'm gonna like what I gonna like. What makes talking movies so fascinating is the fact that we can understand each other's perspective through these conversations. That's why I love talking about this movie. That's why this show exists. That's why it's not just me running in front of a camera. That's why I bring other people on there. I'm not, and also because I'm not that much of a narcissist. I'm a lot of a narcissist, but I'm not that much of a narcissist.
Also, you just don't have a good time when it's just yourself.
That depends on the movie.
Oh, what was that really shitty one that you saw that you had a
review? Love the Coopers.
Oh, no. Oh, there's another one, too.
Home.
Oh, you poor bastard.
There was also, oh, there was one last year. It was a Jeff Bridges medieval movie.
Oh, Seventh Son?
That one I had to see by myself, too. That was a rough time. I remember I saw The Muppets by myself when that movie came out. I had a blast at that
Which
movie.
One?
The Muppets? The new one?
Oh, the second one.
No, the first one.
Oh, yeah.
We didn't review it on the show. This is before I started doing this. But
yeah, that was a great movie.
No, I saw that one by myself. I was like, it was weird because it was me, a grown-ass man with a bunch of little kids in the theater, and I was clapping along with them. I was like, yeah! Fuck yeah! This is great! Love this!
You know what didn't do that? Gods of Egypt!
No. We just sat there bored. I kept checking my phone.
Yeah, remember like, was it where at the hour point? It's like, is this almost over? Ah, there's an hour left!
It really is. It just drags on like, you could have cut half of this shit. There's no reason this needed to be here. And then it's just, I don't know, like, it ties some stuff at humor, and it just, like, it doesn't work. Like, the Sphinx was, like, just weirdly designed and overly chaotic. And, like, even that tries to do that joke, like, oh, Baltha joke at the very end. I was like, was that supposed to be funny? Was that supposed to be an earned moment? Because it doesn't, it just, at times it just drags on. Other times it feels so rushed. It doesn't have a consistent pace.
Just like its special effects.
Yeah, exactly. Just like its special effects. Even when, like, their action scenes might have been decent if you could tell what the fuck was happening.
Oh, I could. I just thought it was... lazy.
Well, that too. But I'm like, well, there's some actually, particularly in the beginning, where it's like, wait, everyone's moving around so far. What is happening here? Yeah. I'm genuinely confused. And like, and designs are just shitty and over the top because it looks ridiculous.
The ironic thing is, like, in the fights, they use so many slow-mo shots. We're just like, at kind of unspectacular moments.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, oh, God, this movie sucked.
Yeah.
Like, oh, what was another thing? So yeah, back to the story. They rescue God of Love. Yeah, get to the Sphinx. Prince of Time finds out that Horus can't
bring... Egypt. No, it's the tits of time that he's trying to save at this point.
Yeah, oh, whatever. But he's not Val Kilmer.
Wait, Val Kilmer?
Yeah, the Prince of Egypt animated movie, remember? Val Kilmer was Moses, I think. It was Moses or Ramses.
I was saying Prince of Persia. Sorry, that's what I was saying.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
I like Prince of Egypt. That's actually a pretty good movie.
Yeah. That was a good religious movie.
It really was. It really is. Like, I'll still put that on every now and then. I was like, this is actually a really solid fucking movie.
Yeah. What else? But, so, also, he finds out that, Horace is lying that he can't bring his girlfriend back.
Yep. Which really should have not have been that big of a surprise.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, I feel like Gerard Butler's combining Leonidas with that character he was in with that Catherine Heigl movie. Heigl.
I know what you're talking about. I just forgot the title because no one cares.
Think
about
Like
it.
A Man.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the one where he was like that bounty. Oh, I was thinking of Bounty Hunter. That was Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah. No, that was still Katherine Heigl. That was Ashton Kutcher that was in the movie, though.
No, there was one where like he.
Oh wait, yeah, I'm thinking of a movie. Sorry. Yeah.
That was like The Killers.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, but.
6 degrees of shit.
Thank God we started doing this show after those movies came out.
We kind of
skipped over the age of Katherine Heigl. Well, except with the Wedding Crashers, that wasn't very good. Not the Wedding Crashers. What the fuck is that movie called? The big Wedding.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she had like one good movie, and that was it.
And then she trash talked that one good movie, and that kind of ended her career.
And
we were talking about anything else other than this movie. We clearly don't have much to say other than it just dragged on. It goes where you think it's gonna go. Galactus shows up and doesn't really do anything. Apparently all it takes is pew pew from the shot of Ra, and that's all it took to defeat the thing. Which means, like, why couldn't they just do that to begin with? But
Well, at one point, in all fairness, when he did try it, it was too late. Because Ra was trying to be as uninvolved as possible.
Mm.
Oh! That's kind of led me to another funnier moment that just kind of also made me think of that stupid, what was the zombie movie with Doc Brown?
I know which one you're talking about.
Dead Before Dawn?
Yeah, that was it.
Where it's like, I know he's not a good ruler, but I don't think you'd fare much better. Literally the next shot is just Egypt burning on fire. Just like, ah! And all I can think was like, you know what? Maybe the radio will calm me down. Everyone's dying!
Nope. The only thing I remember from that movie is, Marty, you forgot your plot device!
Yeah.
That's the only thing I remember from that movie. But I think the one joke I was laughing at myself a little bit was apparently Set goes up there and decides he wants to kill Ra because he's just killing everybody, might as well check him off the list. Does that, kind of. And then turns out, oh no, he's not dead. You can just bring him back if you get him back his little magic
stick. Yeah, I was like,
thing.
Oh, bullshit.
But anyway, so apparently Ra just floating in space like a little Pope Superman. And he gives back, Horace gives him back his staff, and then Ra's eyes open. I just laughed at myself. I heard like Captain Barbossa in my head going, now tell me, who be sailing my ship, chump? Because you get it? Because he's the ship in space. Yeah. Like, that was actually a joke I leaned into halfway through because Horace starts flying into space randomly with Mortal because apparently
he didn't breathe
in space.
Yeah, that was another bit of just like, oh, God, it looks so goofy.
It does. But he's like, okay, whatever. And he flies up to this weird space motherfucker, and I'm like, this is Jupiter Ascending. I've seen this exact same goddamn ship at Jupiter Ascending. Like, it's I mean, obviously it's not. I was like, man, they look so goddamn similar. I can't wait to go on the hour-long talk about space politics. And then the ending just looked like it was shot out from Naboo. I don't know. I'm kind of stretching for shit to talk about this movie. It was just really dumb and boring.
Yeah, there are a lot of moments that didn't feel kind of thought out either. Like, I kind of got a Walking Dead moment.
Which one?
Well, season one game. Where it's like, okay, in the end, it's like Horace has to make a choice where it's like, wait, do I save the mortal or get my eye so I can get the powers and get revenge? And I was thinking, and of course he goes for Beck.
Yeah.
What Egyptian is named Beck? That bugged me the entire thing. It's like, let me get this straight. You named him after a frickin' alternate rock singer.
I was thinking Glenn Beck. That was probably the worst comparison.
Oh, dear. No, I was thinking of musician Beck, who is also in Futurama.
Nice. Oh, my God, you're back. Anyway.
Yeah.
That was actually a joke I made to you halfway through this movie, too, because I was thinking...
Oh, I didn't hear that.
Well, not the Beck joke, but there was the joke that the Set has built this gigantic monument in Egypt to Raw and all that stuff.
Oh, yeah, the Trump Tower.
The Trump Tower. And all I could think of is the Egyptian episode of Futurama where it has a gigantic statue of Bender that just goes, "Remember me!"
Oh, that's what it was!
Remember okay. me!
Yeah.
That's what I was referring to.
Okay.
When was the last time you saw the Egyptian episode?
Oh, it was a while ago.
Okay, that's probably why I don't remember
In
that
In fact,
one.
I think the Beck one was one of the last ones I saw, and that was last night.
Okay, you gotta get back to the Egyption episode. Yeah. See, I've watched all the episodes for Trump, like, five times.
No, I've watched them 2 to 3 times.
Yeah, I met, like, 2 of the members, the cast members of the show, so.
I did, too. Oh, so did I.
Oh, nice. Who'd you meet?
I got up close with John DiMaggio.
Yeah,
and I got a picture with Phil Lamar.
Lisa?
Yeah, he was there, but I didn't get a chance to actually get up close.
Okay.
I know you, of course, you got up close with Reese LaMarche.
Yeah, I mean, like, I've seen the entire cast. I've only met 2 of them, but I would love to meet Billy West. That'd be awesome.
Because I was there at SF Sketchfest where everyone except Katie Sagal was there.
Okay, yeah. But, yeah, I mean, I can't really think of a whole lot more to talk about on this, can you?
But, oh, yeah, let me finish that thing I was talking about.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
So, yeah. So, of course, he decides to go save Beck.
Yeah.
And I was thinking to myself, you know what else would have worked? Just getting the eye and then flying to go save him.
Well, maybe it's an insane process. Maybe it wouldn't have worked. Yeah.
It was just like, no, because as long as he gets both eyes, he has the power.
Well, I mean, don't worry. If he lands on the ground, he can just rewind time. It'll be fine.
But I was just like... Because, okay, the whole point is to teach a lesson, but it's like, it's kind of hard when you realize that there's something that can be done simultaneously that subverts it, admittedly.
Yeah.
Like, it was that issue that I had in the Walking Dead Season 1 game, where, like, in the first episode, you have to decide between saving 2 different people.
Yeah.
And so what I did was I saved the girl with the gun.
Yeah.
Because, you know what she could have done? Shot the zombies who were about to eat the other guy. But no, it was just like, oh, thanks. Chomp. I was like, why? You all had guns. You could have went pew, pew. That was the exact same instance that happened here.
Pew, pew.
Beck, I guess, succumbs to his wounds, which really weren't all that severe from what I remember.
No, it's like, fine.
It's like, you got pushed up against a wall and got your arm cut. How does that constitute dying?
He just died of death. It happens It happens a lot in these movies.
And then after that, Raw's like, oh, dude, you're... Horace, awesome job. You want anything? He's like, yeah, can you bring these 2 suckers back to life?
All right. It's okay. I know the queen of the sea. I can do this. I'm just going to keep making Pirates of the Caribbean jokes.
Yeah. Oh, that's the other thing. Of course, the narration also subverts any tension from that bit.
There's no... if there was any
I say tension, it in air quotes.
Like, there's no tension in this movie. There's no surprises here. And again, it comes back to the CGI. There's no stakes here.
Yeah.
Like, there's no... I don't think anything bad's going to happen to these people. It's only going to work out fine, and it does. I don't know. It's just... Yeah, it's a pretty boring fucking movie.
Oh, God. I'm just glad we got it over with. I'm glad I didn't have to pay for it, and I'm sure you're glad I didn't ask you for food on top of it.
Appreciate that.
Yeah.
But we did get milkshakes before this. Those were good.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of gave me a bit of a cough, but they were fucking good. By the way, if you want a good review, my milkshakes, First Street in San Jose, that's a really fucking good place.
Arguably, it brings all the boys to the yard.
Brings me.
Yep.
All right, so trailers, I guess.
Yeah, which we've talked about almost all the time, though.
Yeah, I guess. So you got, like, Now You See Me 2, which is a sequel. I don't know why it exists.
On the topic of too much CG.
I know, right? Like, that's another thing, like... I think that point... I feel like the movie, like, completely misses the point of what makes magic interesting.
Yeah. I was like, okay, this is all about magic. If you want to, you know...
CGI isn't magic!
Yeah, it's like, hey, guess what? People do these tricks for real. Why not have them do that? Unless they're afraid they're gonna spoil the magic. CG did that.
I was like, you're using just fucking CG. That's not fucking magic. That's just like, oh, you can make some. I'm not convincing anybody. I was like, did anyone ask for this sequel? I don't even know.
I don't think so. No.
Oh God. I don't fucking. Yeah, whatever. It exists. Then we got the Huntsman Winter's War again. What the hell was that?
A chill.
From the Huntsman?
No, AC.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's like, it happens sometimes, which is like, once you get that, you either stroke the right nerve or it gets too cold, just
stroke the right nerve. Gods of Egypt didn't do that. The Tents of Time might have a little bit, but
maybe.
I know. We're pervs. To be fair, movie's kind of presenting that for that.
Seriously, those are the only good things.
I feel like that should be a poll we should make for the fan site, which is like pretentious tits or the Tents of Time. Choose your favorite. But anywho, so when I don't know, like it's one of those things. The Huntsman's like has a lot of people that I like in it. Like who plays the Elsa, basically?
Emily Blunt.
Yeah, I really like her.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, like, if I had to pick someone to play Miss Marvel when that movie comes out, it'd probably be Emily Blunt.
I was going to say Charlize Theron, but that's actually a good choice, too.
I'd probably go with, I think Emily Blunt would get more of the militaristic aspect of the character more.
Yeah, after Edge of Tomorrow. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, so I could totally see Emily Blunt doing that. It's Sicario, don't forget Sicario.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I could totally see her doing that. Much more than Ronda Rousey, which I heard some people suggest. I was like, okay, guys, just because she's a good fighter doesn't mean she should put her in every movie ever.
Yeah, you remember what happened last time she tried to act. Well, last two. Thankfully, the second time she didn't have to say much.
Yeah, she just got her ass kicked. I like that part.
Yeah, just like in real life.
Expendables 3, she was fucking awful in that movie.
I still say there was one. I still say David Ortiz was worse. But... I don't,
but that's difference of opinions there.
Yeah.
Then we got the Batman vs. Superman trailer again. Not the good one. At least the last trailer showed at least the fight scenes will be entertaining. Say what you will about Zack Snyder. There's a lot to say about him, but at least his fight scenes were consistently good.
Yeah, it's like... As I said, there's not a lot that gives me hope. Like, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Ben Affleck as Batman.
I think that's going to be good.
I don't care what anyone else says.
No, I agree.
I'm kind of, like, hopeful because of... Chris Terrio, the writer of Argo, rewrote the script.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Because, oh, God, I hate
it. It includes the lines, oh, you should not pick a fight with this person. But it was like, oh, man. Oh, man.
But
I mean, there's this foreshadowing, then there's that.
Unfortunately, that might have been David S. Goyer. I don't know.
I would not shock me at all if that was David S. Goyer.
I hate David S. Goyer with a freaking passion.
I mean, the only reason the Batman movies were good is because of Christopher Nolan.
Yep. Well, two were great. One was decent.
I still like the third one. I get why people don't.
Yeah. No, third one was another case of the whole... keep getting the phrase. It was not equal to the sum of its parts.
Yeah. I mean, I definitely see that. I totally get that.
And like, as I said, I don't think it's bad. It's just compared to...
No.
It's kind of like The Godfather 3 to the other Godfathers.
That's
like
fair.
It's not necessarily bad. It's just bad compared to those two.
No, I get that. I get that.
Yeah.
I still like that.
No, me too. I just haven't bothered watching it again.
Fair enough.
You should watch it again because it has me. Man. Oh, I like bigger bitch than Boba Fett. Well played, good sir.
Thank you.
But also the fact that supposedly Ben Affleck on his free time, like when he was not when he was not actually filming but still on set, would do rewrites in the Batman suit.
I can just see that. It's like, hey Ben, what you write?
Stuff.
Yeah. What kind of stuff? Justice stuff. Can I see? No.
I am Batman. I'll tell you that little musical number later, which a buddy of mine made. My buddy made it. I just harmonized with it and made it better.
Nice.
Oh, God. Sorry, I'm not going to lie. The thought of that just kind of gives me a little bit of joy.
And then Batman kicked the shit out of Superman.
As I say, that might explain why Batman has taken over this Man of Steel sequel.
Or why he can block Superman's punch.
I'm assuming that spray in that one clip was probably like that weird atmosphere stuff.
Either that or like Kryptonite or something, because I know Kryptonite.
No, remember, Kryptonite's no longer a thing.
No, it's in this movie.
Oh, okay.
They showed in like the first trailer.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah. Then yeah, probably Kryptonite stuff.
Yeah.
I don't have a lot of hope for that movie.
Yeah, it's probably going to be a train wreck, but maybe we'll be surprised. Maybe we'll be pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, I mean, I'm still not happy with Superman. I'm happy they acknowledge the destruction from the first movie this time around, but it's like...
Superman's too much of a dick.
Exactly.
Yeah,
it's
no,
like,
I agree.
It's like, oh god, you turned into Silver Age Superman. That's probably one of the worst incarnations.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd agree on that.
Because just like, I don't expect him to hear from this point on, the bad is dead, like in a very threatening manner.
Mm.
God, it's just... Oh, screw you, David S. Goyer and Zack Snyder. Yeah, sorry, this is a symbol of hope.
Meanwhile, Batman driving us to darkness. No parents.
Super rich kind of makes it better.
Like, it kind of feels like the theme for this movie, to be honest.
Oh, that was the greatest song ever. Oh, God. I remember when we first heard that. We were I think when we heard no parents, we just, like, missed, like, 30 seconds of material.
We did. That was, like, the hardest time I laughed at a movie in a long time was in the Lego movie. Then we got Allegiant, which, I don't know. That's just has Jeff Daniels. We're probably not going to see it because I haven't watched any of the other ones, so I don't really see a point in seeing this one.
Yeah.
I already said the Hunger Games. I'm sent the Maze Runner movies, guys. What do you want from me? I've seen enough of these dumb teen dystopian movies.
Yeah.
Where apparently Chicago is a clean place. Lies and slander.
Well, maybe... Yeah, just, I remember it, like when I heard that, like I suddenly started laughing in the theater.
Yeah, I heard you.
I'm just like, that's funny. This was ridiculous, and saying a Flint, Michigan was a safe haven. if that was a point in the movie, though, I'd be just son of a bitch.
I mean, I just know that Jeff Daniels, a lot of movies I've seen him in hell, just sounds like he's just remorseful of everything he's doing.
Yeah.
Including Dumb and Dumber, too.
That's probably why.
He's like, I'm doing this movie. Okay, go take them and do what you gotta do. I know Jeff Daniels. You deserve better. Although he's good in Steve Jobs. He's really good in Steve Jobs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. So you got any final thoughts for Gods of Egypt?
Don't watch. Just don't watch. I want to go home.
Although, apparently, for anything like our audience, maybe you'll like it. I think it's the hardest you've had of trying not to laugh in a long time.
Oh, wow, that was joyful.
All right, guys, so I think the latest we've got Zootopia and London has fallen, and maybe we'll make time for a third one if there's time.
Boy the Beast! Boy the Beast!
Probably Boy the Beast or anything, because I really don't really give two shits about Whiskey Tango Foxtrot. Sarah expressed some interest, but even though I could tell, like, she wouldn't be heartbroken if she didn't go see it. So.
Yeah. I just would like to watch a good movie from a director whose stuff I've enjoyed.
Who directed it?
I can't remember if it's Boy and the Beast or Beast and the Boy.
I think it's Beast.
But it was done by the guy who did this movie called Summer Wars. He's a director for an anime studio called Madhouse.
Okay.
So...
Because I know I saw a poster for that at the AMC 20. I was like, oh, what the hell is that? But, it's Miyazaki looking motherfucker.
Yeah,
but
funny thing is, like, his posters all tend to look the same, too, now that I think about it.
I haven't seen any of the posters, but...
Yeah, when we get the chance, then, if I can, I'll show you Summer Wars after that, maybe, or something like that.
Maybe. We'll find out. All right, guys, I think that's all we got. So, thank you all for watching. See you all later this week.
See ya.